Introduction. So coming next to hypothesis, a research question leads to a research hypothesis. And usually in a research proposal, either we write a research question or a research hypothesis, and usually do not mention both, because once we know about a research question, we know what a hypothesis can be is there also. So hypothesis, what is hypothesis? It is a calculated prediction on the direction and magnitude of the results. We are predicting the results actually in hypothesis. So there are two types of hypothesis stated for purpose of disproving one. The null hypothesis states that there is no difference, no relationship between the independent and dependent variable, or nothing is there to explain. The groups identified based on independent variable are similar when they are compared based on the results of the outcome variable. Both groups compared are similar in the outcome. So that is what is null hypothesis states. Null hypothesis states that there is no difference. A directional hypothesis says that there is a difference and the difference is towards one group. So for example, group A, non-smokers, have less periodontal disease than group B, smokers. And this is a prediction given in the hypothesis. So hypothesis says that non-smokers have less periodontal disease than smokers. So you know there's a direction in it. And this prediction is based on previous studies or similar studies in different population. Or another hypothesis, which is a directional one, can be the prevalence of diabetes in Indian population is 20%. And this 20% was based on previous research in other similar population. Now, we can evaluate and test whether this prediction of 20% is true or not. If it is true, then this hypothesis is proved. Sometimes we can give a non-directional hypothesis. We do not know how the results will swing, whether it will be towards a group A or to the group B. Then we have a non-directional hypothesis when the direction cannot be predicted from previous literature. There is a difference between group A and group B in the presence of disease, but we do not know which will have a higher disease, whether group A or group B. That is a non-directional hypothesis. Hypothesis statement is written with independent variable first, followed by the dependent variable. So research hypothesis again are predictions on the answer to the research question, the expected relationship among variables. Gives a clue for the selection of the statistical tool. Now coming to the next research objectives, or the description of specific action to reach the aim, which suffices the research purpose. So that is what a research objective. The actions that will lead to a conclusion aligned to the research purpose. Overall objective and specific objectives. What is overall objectives? Overall objective is how the overall aim will be achieved. Specific objectives are small objectives, individual measurable activity that will lead to a fulfillment of the overall objective. So objectives usually have action verbs to identify, to describe, to compare between two groups on the disease status. So these will be the action verbs used to describe an objective. Let us do another activity. On the problem and question created earlier, state the objectives, actions you're going to take, and hypothesis as activity 4 in the same Word file as before. Send the file after activity 4 to the given email address in the file for feedback. Or if you do not have the Word file, scan the QR code and access the Word file. Pause the video for scanning the QR code.